Shalom, shalom. Welcome. Giving all praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Yahweh Shah. I'm Monique Ariella, and here's Tazada.
So shalom, shalom, call me Asha Allah. Once again, you're not in the sounds of the voice of your brother Tazada, and again,
Monique Ariel.
So I'm just here to give you an update. This book is The Infliction of Commerce, the first one that I actually put out. This book has very detailed information in it. Many of you, you talk the talk, yeah, I want to be a secure party creditor, but you're not reading the literature that teaches you how to properly handle contract law. You got to come to the comprehension that contract is law and law is contract. It's all about offer acceptance, offer acceptance. When you receive an offer, what do? Do you go into acquiescence, silence, which means you do nothing, or do you argue like a debtor? Many of you cannot escape that debtor mentality. You just love polemics. You love to argue. You love the art of disputation. You're addicted to it. But now it's time to change your life, and you can start by getting this book right here. Another book is that right there. This is the second edition, Commercial Warfare. We the People versus Despotism. Whether you're a secure party creditor or you're becoming a secure party creditor, this book is valuable in your library. It teaches you how I actually construct writs, affidavits of negative averment, how I handle like commercial presentments. There's so much information in this book, the acceptor for value method. There's many different ways that you could actually construct an acceptor for value. Do you have this book on your shelf? If you're not, you're harming yourself. Many of you just want to file the secure party creditor paperwork, but you don't want to read this literature. Therefore, you don't know how to stand as a man or a woman. And no, that's not a mispronunciation. It's not a misnomer. A woman. A man with a womb, which is the womb man. That has the womb where your seed grows. So you got to get these books. The other book, my latest book, is Red Pill Right Knowledge versus the Feminist. What's the name of this book? I don't forgot the name. Red Pill, Right Knowledge versus the De Facto Feminist Allegory. Now, this book, I pretty much developed for men and women that's actually having issues with child custody, child support. It shows you how I actually tackle these issues in court and won every time. So you definitely want this in your library, because if you are not affected by child custody or child support, you definitely know someone that is. So all of these things are actually a wealth of knowledge. Let me put this down. Then let me have that one. Another book that's actually dealing with nationality. Let me get those. It's just on Hebrew Israelite. So many of you change your status, but you don't claim nationality. You want to stay in a corporate ward status. Check this out. You cannot be in a proper status and you're still walking around with the name of your former slave masters. I'm not being racist. You can get in your emotions all you want to, but it's not going to change anything, and it's not going to change the truth. It's not going to change the fact that as long as you're carrying someone else's name, you cannot consider yourself to be in a proper status. You cannot have proper standing. They will look at you and laugh. So become the creditor. I'm telling you, many of you have the question like, what should I do first? Change my nationality and so on and so forth, claim my nationality, or become a secure party creditor? Become a secure party creditor first. Why do I say that? Because you want to be able to discharge debt under the corporation, under the fictitious name, under that name. So you want to actually become a creditor under that name, and then later you could, claim your proper nationality. You know what I'm saying? For the record. But to become a secure party creditor, you want to do it under that corporate construct, that corporation name, in legis. You understand what I'm saying?
Sexually. Well, I know a lot of people who are ex-felons. They've been out of trouble for many years now, 5+ years. And they get to that good job, and then all of a sudden that old felon or a felony comes back to bite them when they haven't been in any trouble. Is there going to be any information about how to get your record expunged? Things of that nature?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if they follow what's actually being stated, then you will actually learn how to possibly expunge a criminal record. And in states like California and so on and so forth, they're trying to make it more difficult. But if you learn, I keep emphasizing to people, you got to learn contract law. And you got to learn to look at everything as an offer. You know, stop like reading into the little meticulous things that's of like little significance. It's all about offer and acceptance. People that's on parole, many of you want to know how to deal with a parole situation. Well, a parole situation is a contract. Contracts are dynamic. And if you are a contract law expert, you can make them move, which means you can make that particular contract work in your favor. Understand that.
Thank you. Okay, my next question is, I have a brother that owns property in Africa. He owns the house, but he doesn't own the land that it's on, and he's worried about taxes or whatnot. Will you be covering anything about that subject?
First of all, excuse me for not saying this in the beginning. Giving all praises to the God of our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose proper name is Yahweh, Yahuwah. If he's actually paying property taxes, he doesn't own it. He just thinks he owns it. Because anytime that you're paying any kind of property taxes, that means there's a trust involved. That means the de facto state has legal title over that property. And if he does not pay the property taxes, that property would actually be taken away from him. So what he actually has to learn to do is to actually get a land patent or to dissolve that trust.